Mr. President, Mr. Vice President, dear colleagues, this report on of European Parliament recommendations on the direction of EU-Russia political relations is a report of really important on very important topic. Russia is an important country which makes big influence on all the developments in the eastern part of European continent, and EU needs to have a clear long-term strategy with a clear goals and clear instruments of our policy towards Russia. Our report is based on several clear principles. First of all, we want to have good relations with Russia, but it depends on Russia. With Russia, led by authoritarian, kleptocratic and aggressive, both domestically and externally, Putin regime, it is impossible to have good relations. Russia of today is the greatest threat to European security. Second principle, we are making clear difference in our attitude towards Kremlin regime and towards Russian people and Russian society, who are the first victims of such a regime. We are very critical on Kremlin regime and very positive and optimistic about the future of Russian society. Third principle, we are absolutely sure that in the future Russian people will live with European-type democratic system of governance. If Ukrainians can do it, if Belarusians are striving for it, there are no reason why Russian people cannot go the same way. And we are absolutely sure that in the future, EU will have good and pragmatic relations with democratic Russia. Report gives several clear recommendations to EU institutions on EU future policy towards Russia. First of all, to concentrate our efforts on a very clear long-term goal, how to assist Russian people to transform their country back to democratic European-type development. This is the first time when the European Parliament gives such a clear direction on the major goal of EU political relations with Russia. The report elaborates the strategy of EU political relations with Russia should have three major pillars: push back, contain, and engage. It sounds in a very similar way like it was first declared by Vice President Borrell, but in the report, maybe we're bringing more precise and concrete content of those three pillars. The first pillar, push back. Push back against Kremlin aggressive policies of today, both external and internal policies. Clear non-recognition policy of occupations and annexations in Crimea, South Ossetia, Donbass. More effective type sanctions, which should be better coordinated with transatlantic partners, including sanctions against oligarchs. Possibility of non-recognition of legitimacy of elections if they will be stolen. An effective implementation of Green Deal as an instrument to cut EU dependency on Russian gas, and so on. Second pillar, containment pillar, speaks how to contain Kremlin hybrid influences and how to make EU clean and safe of Russia hybrid threats and corruption practices inside of EU. If we want to help democrats in Russia to transform their country and to get rid of Kremlin autocracy, we need to make ourselves clean from Kremlin influences. And the third pillar, engage. Engage not only with Kremlin, but engage strategically with civil society of Russia. Let us offer Russian people clear vision what kind of relationship we are going to establish in between of EU and democratic Russia. With a free trade agreements, EU-Russia real modernization partnerships, and so on. That is what we can do in the future. Russian people need to know that transformation of their country will be beneficial to all of them who now are the first victims of the authoritarian and corrupt regime. What else can we offer? Let's offer Russian people also inspiration and example to follow. Much more ambitious EU support to build success of Eastern Partnership region, especially association trio countries, Ukraine, Moldova, and Georgia. Their success, built with more ambitious EU integration policy, could bring a real inspiration to Russian people to follow similar democratic way of development. And the last point, as you know, this weekend there will be elections to State Duma in Russia, so-called elections. Lukashenko last year have stolen election results after elections. Putin is trying to steal them even before elections. More than 100 most important opposition or independent candidates were not allowed to participate in elections. Navalny is in prison. No OSCE observers are allowed to come. Our report recommends not to recognize Parliament of Russia as legitimate one if elections will be recognized as fraudulent and having been conducted in violation of democratic principles and international law. That is why next week will be a test also to all of us, to EU institutions, not to be afraid to say that elections were organized in violation of democratic principles and international law, since even now there are a lot of evidence that this is the case. Our report is a message to Russian people, where together with them, we need Russia as a good neighbor with whom we can have good relations. We want Russian people to enjoy the same human rights, the same rule of law and democracy privileges as we have and we enjoy. We want Russian people to enjoy a modern and prosperous country. Such a development of Russia would be beneficial for Russian people and for the whole Europe. And EU can do a lot to assist Russian people in such a transformation of their country. EU needs to understand and accept its exceptional role and responsibility in such a transformation. And first of all, EU needs to overcome its restlessness as it was diagnosed by Munich Security Conference and Wolfgang Ischinger. Our report brings recommendations how to overcome this restlessness in political relations with Russia. The report was supported by a large majority and consensus among major political groups in Foreign Affairs Committee. Such unity is also a strong signal to Kremlin. I hope that the same unity we shall be able to keep here in the plenary. And I would like to thank all the shadow rapporteurs with whom it was a real pleasure to elaborate this important report. Thanks a lot.